Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's webinar co-hosted by the New York Oracle's User Group and Oracle Partner Viscosity North America. My name is Katie Barnes. I am an account manager here at Viscosity. For those of you who might not be familiar with us, Viscosity is a full Oracle stack consulting firm with a core expertise in Oracle database, including RAC, Apex, zero downtime migrations, performance tuning, and high availability. We also have decades of experience with infrastructure, including engineered systems. During today's presentation, feel free to submit any questions to our presenter in the questions and chat prompt seen on the lower right side of the GoToWebinar panel. Today's presenter will address what he can during their presentation and will also reserve a few minutes at the end of the webinar to answer any unanswered questions if time allows. Representing the New York Oracle User Group is NYOUG President Coleman Leviter. Coleman will be introducing you to today's presenter and to NYOUG. So with that being said, I'll go ahead and hand it over to you, Coleman.
Thank you, Katie. Welcome everybody to our ongoing series of these Oracle topic webinars. Just a little brief introduction about New York Oracle Users Group. We were formed in 1984 for the exchange of ideas and assistance and support among users of Oracle software products. I get the thing on. You can connect with us on Twitter, Meetup, LinkedIn, Facebook, and our website, which all the webinars that we've co-hosted with Viscosity are on our website. Just look for the presentations and you'll see it there at nyoug.org. And outreach to our members at the Oracle User Group community at oracle.com community user groups. And again, I want to thank Viscosity North America for co-hosting these series of webinars with us. Now a brief introduction for Mark Suits. He's Director of Software Development for Oracle Applications Express in Oracle's Database Tools Division. Mark is responsible for managing the development and delivery of Apex, Oracle's premier low-code development platform. Mark has been with Oracle since 1998. After working for Oracle Consulting in Germany and the US for a number of years, he joined the Apex development team in 2002. Mark lives in New York City with his family and holds a master's degree in computer science from the University of Applied Sciences in Wedel, Germany. Again, thank you everybody for joining this webinar series, and we'll turn it over to Mark.
All right, thank you, Coleman. Let me share my screen. All right, so you should hopefully see my screen now. I'm sharing my whole screen because I'm going to jump back and forth between PowerPoint and my web browser. All right, let's get started. Yeah, thanks again for the introduction. I've been with the Apex team for a very long time. And today I want to do a beginner's guide, help you all get started with Apex. And if you already know Apex, hopefully there are a few things that you might learn as well. So we're going to start by talking a little bit about what Apex is, what we do with it, what the use cases are. Then I want to do a brief demonstration of what you can do with it, and then really get into how you get started, how to sign up, and point you to all the resources available for you to learn more about Apex, to get training, to look at videos, to go for help. And then I'll do another demonstration of some of the basics of building applications with Apex. Right, again, a brief introduction here. If you want to connect with me on Twitter or LinkedIn, you'll find my information here. And we'll share these slides with you afterwards. There are going to be a lot of links in here that I'm referencing, so you don't need to copy and paste them all or screenshot them. You'll get all the slides later. All right, safe harbor statement. Today, I'm not going to talk much about what's coming, but typically when we do new feature presentations and touch on plans for the future, this is our safe harbor statement stating that if we do talk about future features, they are subject to change. All right, so what's Apex? Let's start with a basic definition. It's a low-code development platform that enables you to build scalable and secure enterprise apps. So the idea is that you use Apex to build all kinds of applications that you might need in your company or even for your personal needs, any kind of application running on the web, applications running in a web browser. And we call Apex a low-code tool. Low-code is a term that Forrester defined a couple of years ago. It refers to development frameworks, development tools that allow you to build fully functional applications without having to write a lot of code. There's always going to be a little bit of code there, right? You have to select the data source, maybe type in a SQL query, but by and large, you can build fully functional applications with Apex and other local tools with really very minimal need to write a lot of code. So the benefits that you get from low-code tools are that you can get started very quickly. You typically just sign up for an online service or you install the tool on your local machine. And those tools generally provide rich functionalities. There are going to be components like interactive reports and charts and data entry forms and calendars and other widgets that are pre-built for you. You only need to supply data source and then you get fully functional components very quickly. So you're going to be very productive. You can get to fully functional applications within minutes, at least for prototyping, and there's a lot less coding required. So those tools are generally much more productive than your typical JavaScript or Java frameworks. And you'll be able to release your apps much faster with Apex. You build your app, you push a deploy button, and it's ready for your users to start working with. So then how does Apex fit into the picture? Apex is a low-code development platform. We call it a platform because most customers are using it in some sort of online service. The IDE, what you see here on the screen, that's a web page. You connect to Apex using your web browser, and you start building applications with Apex within your web browser. That's where you kind of call it a platform, and you use Apex to build apps to typically manage your data that you have either in your local Oracle database or remotely via REST-enabled SQL and REST APIs. I'm going to talk more about that in a moment. Apex is a low-code tool, but if you do have Oracle skills, if you have SQL skills, if you know some pure SQL, that's certainly helpful for building applications and customizing your applications. Likewise, if you know JavaScript, you have a lot more options on the client side to do customizations. But in general, it's very easy to learn, develop, and deploy. So I'm hoping after this session today, you'll be able to sign up for an Apex service and build your first basic Apex app within a few minutes, maybe an hour or two. But you should be able to build a basic app pretty quickly on your own. And we target Apex as a lot of different developer types because it's a low-code tool, because you don't have to write a lot of code yourself. We target Apex as, I guess, what's called citizen developers or line of business developers. So people, employees who know a lot about their business, but who are not necessarily professional coders, right? Like business users, business analysts who may today use some other desktop solutions, Access, Excel, or something else to kind of build the kind of ad hoc apps they need. They might choose Apex to just build their apps, their systems in a more secure, more professional managed way. But Apex is certainly open to professional developers and data scientists as well. If you just want to build an application, there's no need to really build up the entire infrastructure yourself and write every single line of code yourself. So a lot of use cases are certainly relevant to professional developers as well. And I do want to point you to our apexoracle.com website, and in particular to our low-code page there. So let me go over to my browser. So this is apexoracle.com. Let's just go with the base URL. So if there's anything you're taking away from our session here today, remember this, apexoracle.com. This is where you go to get started. And this is where you can learn about what Apex is, what you can do with it, learn about the community, other solutions built by with Apex. And you can also learn more about low code. So when you go to this menu over here, go to a low code. We talk a lot about what that actually means. We talk about the developer experience using low code tools, how you have easy to use declarative wizards, how you have a graphical interface to develop your applications, and how you can customize your UI. We talk about how much more quickly you can develop applications and the consistency gains that you get by having these pre-built components rather than kind of building everything from scratch. We talk about how you kind of minimize your defects, right? Like the less code, the fewer lines of code you write, the fewer bugs you might be introducing. So by using these pre-built components, you're certainly reducing the risk of introducing bugs and defects. That makes it certainly a lot less expensive. Building applications quicker and building applications that are more consistent and have fewer bugs helps you reduce your costs. And they're also a lot easier to maintain. They're just declarative definitions that you need to look after. You don't have to dig through all the code and figure out what might go wrong. So take a look at this low code write-up here. And I want to especially highlight this claim here, eliminate 98% of hand coding with Apex. When you click here on this learn more, you can read up how much quicker you can be with Apex and how much less code you have to write. There's actually a study that we worked with Peak Solutions on. And this study you can download from this page over here. And that really goes into much detail on why we make that claim, why we state that you'll be this much faster with this much less code compared to more traditional coding methods. And going back to my slides here for a moment, I kind of highlighted our charts on that a little bit. So what we've done in this time and motion study is we had an experienced JavaScript developer using React.js, developing certain components like faceted search, interactive grids and such using React, and then comparing this to how long it took and how much code had to be written using Apex. So again, take a look at that study. I copied this graphic or this diagram or table from that study that really goes into detail how much less code and how much quicker development with Apex was. So very interesting resource to learn more about low code. But let's talk a little bit about use cases for Apex. And again, I kind of want to circle back to our website here from time to time, because that's really your best resources to learn about Apex. So take a look at solutions and then use cases to get a better idea of what you can build with Apex. We always talk about, I guess, what we call opportunistic apps. That's what I touched on in the beginning, where you kind of work in a department, you're a business user, you have a need to plan an event or track your customers or track some tasks or whatnot, where you need an application quickly, but usually your IT department doesn't really have time to build your build that up for you. So you kind of look for other ways to kind of build these apps. And one of these ways certainly is Apex, where you can quickly build apps yourself. Spreadsheet replacement, kind of the same use case. You have a need to track some data, and you have to need to share your data with your peers. Often we see Excel being used and Excel spreadsheets being emailed around. That's not always the best idea. It's not a very multi-user friendly if you email a spreadsheet around and everybody makes the edits and then you kind of try to put it all back together. It's not a database, so spreadsheet replacement is another use case. But then from there, you kind of get into more enterprise style applications. Oracle Forms has been around for a very long time, and a lot of customers have been looking to move their Forms apps to a more modern web-based user UI user experience for a long time, and Apex is one of the tools out there that help customers do that and that allow Forms developers to kind of feel at home, because we share many of similar concepts, the declarative development using SQL and pure SQL, building applications on data in the Oracle database. So there are a lot of similarities that make it easy for Oracle Forms customers to modernize their apps with Apex. And then from there, we get to external data sharing. You want to build an application and you want to have your customers, your partners participate and edit and view data in these applications. So with Apex and our cloud services, you can very easily build apps quickly that you can share with organizations outside your own corporate network. And then data mart reporting, SaaS and e-business extensions. You have Oracle e-business suite, you have Fusion applications, you have some other systems where you need to write extensions to Apex is often a very good fit to build these kinds of extensions and build functionality that's missing. Just to kind of highlight a few things that where Apex was used for by Oracle. One is shop.oracle.com. That's Oracle's online store. So if you want to buy any Oracle products online, you go to shop.oracle.com, and this is an Apex application. So if you want to sign up for a cloud service, if you want to buy on-premise software, this application has been built with Apex. And then over the last year or so, we were heavily involved in Oracle's pandemic response. So we were, Oracle built a lot of applications for the US government to track medications, to help with the distribution of vaccinations and such. And these applications were built with Apex. And there are a number of resources or press releases that talk about it. And I'll include a few links in my PowerPoint slide that I'm going to share. But I want to point you to this article here by the DNet that kind of talks about the backstory, how Apex came to be used for these efforts and how we went about it. It's a very interesting article to kind of read how we can build these kind of applications and deploy them very quickly. All right, so that's on the use cases. So again, this is available on apexoracle.com. And I touched on our spreadsheet, so I came across this picture the other day. I thought it really represents very nicely why you should be using spreadsheets. So I want to start by showing you how you can turn a spreadsheet into a Apex application, and then later on I get a little bit more into how you sign up for a workspace and how you actually get started building apps. So let's start with this spreadsheet over here. This is something that I've been using in a previous presentation to kind of show how you can build an Apex app with based on spreadsheet data. And this particular one, I live in New York and I live in Brooklyn. I have two kids, and 2 years ago we were looking for high schools for my son, and the New York City high school system is a little bit tricky, so you have to look at a lot of different options and look at a lot of different methods, and I figured I'll build an application that helps me with those selections. So this is a spreadsheet that shows you the borough, shows you the name of the school, shows you the neighborhood, the type of school, shows you the admission method, and that gives you some stats around number of students, graduation rate, and some stats around how safe school is perceived, how many seats are available, and so on. So I'm going to take this spreadsheet, I'm going to upload it into Apex, and then I'm going to build an application on top of it, and then I'm going to share this with all of you to try out. So let's go to Apex. Let's sign into my workspace over here. Well, actually, let me So this is the Apex login screen, and now of course I forgot my login here. All right, so that's not gonna work, so let's do this instead. All right, so this is a different instance. I'm gonna do my demo here. So you go to the application builder, you go to create a new application. I'm going to go back in a moment to show you how you get there. And then you wanna start from a file because I'm starting with a spreadsheet. So I'm going to take this spreadsheet here, and I can either just copy and paste the data, or I can pick the file. So I'm just gonna paste this all in. I'm gonna hit next. And then I'm going to create a new table, and I do have my first line containing my column headers. I'm going to call this high schools. All right, so that looks good. So what's happening now is that Apex is going to create a table for me. And it's going to load these 427 rows into that table. I'm going to create application. This takes me to the create application wizard. The create application wizard is a tool or a wizard that lets you start building applications, so you can build apps on spreadsheet in my case, or on existing tables in your database. And because I uploaded the spreadsheet data, it pre-created these four pages here for me: a dashboard, a search page, and an intake of report with form. And that all looks good to me. I'm going to also check all these features, and then I'm going to go ahead and create this app. So what's happening now is that Apex looks at my application definition. Based on that definition, it is creating metadata in my Apex schema. So I'm not actually generating code. I'm not generating any JavaScript or PLSQL code. I'm writing metadata that defines this app. And then later on, when I'm running this application, Apex or the Apex engine is reading out this data and rendering those web pages for me. Let's give it another minute here. All right, that takes longer than expected. There you go. So now I created this application, and now I'm actually ready to run this. I'm going to hit run here. I'm going to log in with my username and password. And this is my app. So I have a dashboard, I have a high school search, I have a high school report, and now I can take a look at this dashboard. And the first thing that happened is that Apex was smart enough to look at the data and create some reasonable charts here for me on this dashboard that might be relevant to me based on this data analysis. So I get a chart, a pie chart of the different boroughs, and I can see how many high schools there are in each borough. I can also look at this by neighborhood, like let's say Williamsburg has 6 high schools and Union Square Chelsea has 11. And then I can look at the different interests, and I can also look at the different admission methods. So that looks pretty good. That's helpful. Next, I want to actually find a proper high school, and I kind of know what I'm looking for. So I can use what we call faceted search to reduce my result set. So all of this was generated for me just by uploading the spreadsheet and making a few choices in this create app wizard. So with this faceted search report, I can now reduce my result set. I know that I live in Brooklyn. I only want to see Brooklyn schools. And as I make changes here, you'll see how all these numbers over here kind of get updated, right? So I kind of take Brooklyn back out, and the numbers are back up, and I can even look at these charts and see they're like 241 ad-op schools, 76 screen schools. Once I pick Brooklyn again, those numbers change. And then I know I want to have a high attendance rate. And as I make more choices, everything keeps changing. I want to have a very safe school. So there you go. So now I already reduced my result set to just 9 schools. That's pretty nice. And I also know that I'm looking for screen schools. So with that, I'm down to just 4 options. So this worked pretty well. And this one actually ended up the school where my son was accepted. So I kind of pretty much reduced my choices here to the right schools. And then lastly, also have this high school report. And in this report, you can look at all your data in a tabular way, and you can open it up and make changes and make edits. So this is just very briefly, very kind of a brief introduction into what building an application, Apex application actually looks like. And when you go to administration, you can also manage your users. And I know that I have like this demo user here, which I want to allow as a contributor. And then I'm gonna close this, gonna exit out, gonna log back in. And now I'm a different user. I don't see the administration option anymore, but I still can use this dashboard. So in those like 3-4 minutes, I now built this fully functional application, and I'm actually ready to deploy this and share this with everybody who wants to try this out. So I'm going to take this link here. I'm going to put the link into a chat. So if you actually want to try out this application yourself, take a look at this chat in your webinar panel. And then when you want to log in, the username is demo, and the password is NYOUG123. So with that information, demo NYC, that's NYOUG123, you can actually go in and try out this application that I just built. All right, so try this out. Meanwhile, I'm going to go back to my slides here and I'm going to talk a little bit more about Apex. Again, pointing you back to apexoracle.com, we have a number of success stories. So if you want to learn about what other customers are doing with Apex, take a look at that. Apexoracle.com success stories. There are a number of success stories here. When you click here on learn more, you actually get a more detailed write-up, what was the business challenge, why they chose Apex, why they chose Oracle, why they chose Apex, and how they went about building these solutions. Telstra, Vodafone, so a lot of customer success stories that we are publishing here and that you can learn more about what they've done with Apex. I also want to point you to this Gartner Peer Insights, which just came out. So when you go to this page, go to read more, you're being taken to this Gartner Peer Insights and customer choice that they're giving out for different low-code platforms, and Apex is listed here. So click on this, and then you can look at all the reviews that we've received for Apex and see a little bit more about what customers think about Apex and what they've done with Apex. So lots of interesting resources to learn more about Apex, success stories, customer feedback. And again, those links are going to be included in that slide deck that I'm sharing later. A few more stats. We estimate that we have around 500,000 developers using Apex. This is based on Oracle support requests. This is based on our check for updates, the stats that we're collecting based on Apex usage. So roughly 500 developers are using Apex worldwide. There are millions of apps that have been created with Apex. There are about 6,000 new applications created every day. When you look at this service that I was using earlier, apexoracle.com, on that instance alone, we have 50,000 workspaces, 50,000 customers using this single instance. So there's a lot of activity going on there. 50,000 customers versus developers, so 50,000 companies worldwide using Apex. And we also have about 150 partners and consulting companies that work with Apex and provide Apex services. All right, a little bit view back into history. Apex actually started in 2004-2005, first as an online service, HTMLDB.com, apexoracle.com, which is still around. That site that I was using earlier, that's still there. Application that I built 10, 15, 16, 18 years ago, they still run there. I can still bring them up and upgrade them to our latest versions. And then we've been bringing out releases ever since. More recently, we started with a twice a year release cycle. So we release in the spring and the fall. starting with Apex 18.1. We are now up to Apex 20.2, and we are working on Apex 21.1 coming out later this year. So two releases every year. And Apex is also available on a number of different cloud services that I'm going to highlight here in a moment. But let's see how you can actually get started, how you can build those kind of apps that I just demonstrated. And there are a number of different options, again, going back to apexorg.com. But the number of different options, right? You can run Apex on the cloud. There's the autonomous database service that includes Oracle Apex. There's a dedicated autonomous database that also includes Apex. There's a new Apex application development service available where you really just focus on Apex development. You can also install Apex on the database cloud service and manage the whole service yourself. And you can go to apexoracle.com, which is our free schema service. Now, if you want to run it on premises, if you want to install it locally on your laptop, on your corporate server, you can certainly download Apex. You can install it into any Oracle database. With our current release, it's 11.2 and upwards, including Oracle Database XE, which is our free database. You can also sign up for third-party clouds. So if you want to run Apex on Amazon or other cloud or hosting providers, anywhere where you can run the Oracle database, you can run Apex as well. All right, let's take a look at some of these options. So I talked about the cloud, and let me go back in here. So this is my Oracle Cloud Service. Let me log back in here. So you go to cloudoracle.com, you sign up for a trial. The trial gives you some free forever services. So you get like $300, $500 credit that you can use for the first months. But even beyond that time, there are certain services that are available to you for free. They're marked with this always free eligible, right? So on this instance, I signed up for autonomous transaction processing. I could also sign up for Apex application development and create an Apex instance here, but I already have this ATP instance, so I'm going to go over here. And in here, I have Brooklyn Queens, my two services that I can use to develop Apex applications. So this is the Oracle Cloud, this is the autonomous database, and you have choices between autonomous transaction processing and autonomous data warehousing, depending on your workload. And you can sign up for Apex application development if only all you need is Apex development. You can also go to apexoracle.com, the site that we looked at a couple of times by now. When you click here on Get Started for Free, we talk about all these options a little bit more. You can look at these videos that kind of walk you through actually signing up for it. And if you want to sign up for apexoracle.com, you click here on Request a Free Workspace, and then you fill in your information. And then you step through this wizard, pick your country. Are you new to Oracle? Do you use it for training? Why do you want to use it? Then you find our terms and conditions. And then you can go ahead and create a workspace. You'll receive an email after a few minutes. You click on that email link, and after that, you get a workspace that you can use to build Apex applications. All right. I already created a workspace ahead of time, so let me go back to my workspace here. So once you have a workspace, you log into that workspace with your credentials. And then the first thing that you see are those four components, the application builder, SQL workshop, team development, and the application gallery. And I'm going to go back to the application builder here in a moment, but I do want to highlight SQL workshop. SQL Workshop allows you to run SQL commands. So if you want to do your good old select start from AMP, you would do that in here. And then similar to SQL Developer or SQL Developer Web, you also have an object browser where you can look at the tables and views and objects and pure SQL code that you have in your database schema. I don't have any procedures right now, but this allows you to look at these objects, to create new tables, to compile PL/SQL code with a browser-based UI into your database. And then back to the Apex homepage, there's also team development. Team development is what you use to communicate with your development team. The first time you go to your workspace, you can choose which kind of options you want to pre-install. If you just want to learn about it, I would recommend installing all these sample labels and sample templates. Oh, then I picked Portuguese. Okay, well. And then once you're on this page, you can start communicating with your peers, right? So you kind of create these Stack Overflow style postings. You can reply back. You can do some basic formatting using Markdown. You can submit your comments, and you can look at your comments and kind of have a discussion going on your application, on the development efforts, and all of this is kind of tightly integrated to your actual application, so you can comment and interact with your development team on your application development efforts. And then lastly, we have the application gallery. The application gallery includes a number of sample applications and productivity applications. So if you just want to get started with Apex, if you want to learn more about how do you data loading, how do you do interactive reporting and grids and charts, take a look at these samples that kind of show you how to build those kind of components. If you want to build, learn more about project management, customer tracking, install these productivity applications, they're a good starting point for you to kind of build your own solutions. All right, but I do want to introduce you how to get started with Apex. So let me show you how you actually build an application based on your own new data model. Like what I've shown you earlier was creating an app on a spreadsheet, and often you might have some existing tables, but what if you want to just really start from scratch and build your own little database model and build an application on top of it? You would go to a SQL workshop, look if you already have any tables or start creating tables, or you would use a tool like this QuickSQL tool that we introduced a few releases back, which makes it really easy to create your own tables quickly. So let's say I want to build a task management or to-do application. I would kind of think about what kind of data I want to track. There would certainly be assignees, right? And then the assignee would have a first name, and the last name, and an email. And then that assignee would have some to-dos. And the to-do would have a to-do name and a due date. And as I'm typing in all of this, you see here on the right-hand side, you get a fully baked SQL syntax that you can actually run and create these tables for you. This also allows you to create some demo data, right? I can do like insert 20. And then you actually get a lot of sample data pre-created for you. There's a lot of syntax to this language, which we document over here. There are also some samples, and this one was modeled after this to-do sample. So when I'm loading this whole model in here, you'll see again, full name, email, phone number, due date, priority, status, and such. And then based on this, I get the full database model here on this right-hand side. So it kind of looks good to me. That kind of looks like the kind of database that I want to build my app on top on. So I'm going to save the SQL script, call this to-dos, save this, and I'm going to review and run this. So this is the script that I would run. So let's do run, and then hit run again. All right, so that looked good. 67 statements processed, data loaded, tables created. Now let's go ahead and create the application. And this now takes me back to the create application wizard. And now you, again, as before, you see like these pages pre-created based on the data and based on the structure that I'm predefined. So let's call this to-dos. I can add additional pages, right? If I want to have a calendar, if I want a faceted search, I could add all of these things right now, or I can add them later. And then we're going to check all the features, create application. And now, just like before, a new application gets created. This application gets defined as metadata again inside my Apex schema. And then I should have a ready build application. All right, just give me one more minute here. And once that application is ready, I'm going to put the link into chat again. You should be able to try this out as well. All right, yeah, while this is running, I'm looking at the incoming feedback here. So I guess one of the questions that I'm seeing here in the question and answer is about database links. You can use database links, but what you should look at is really our ways to interact with remote data sources through REST APIs and REST-enabled SQL. I'm gonna touch on that a little bit, hopefully in a moment. So this is my new application. I'm gonna run this. And this is my starting URL, right? Like this whole login, we don't necessarily start to run this. So with that URL, you just go here, and I'm gonna put this into chat. And then you log in again with that same username and password that I used before, which is not gonna work right away. Sorry about that. You do need to add a demo to the access control list. So let me quickly do that. So I'm gonna make you all a contributor. So now you should be able to log in, demo and NYOUG123. Log in, there it is. And now you can look at your assignees. Those are the demo data sets that I created with a full name, email, and a very short phone number. And then you can also go to the to-do list and look at the list of to-dos and start editing your to-dos. So very quick and easy way for you to build out your first starter application with Apex. And now you can start making changes, right? Like some of the things that kind of stick out here, this kind of looks good, like having a select list, but this field got created a little bit too big. So you can click on this edit page, which takes you to what we call the page designer. And this is really our main IDE. This is where you go to edit your pages. And in here, I want to change the name. I'm gonna change the name to text field. I'm gonna hit save. Now when I go back, it looks better. So by tracking, so that's just a field now, and I can start making my changes in here. And if I make your changes, you'll see them instantly affected in this report. Another thing that could be nice to change would be like the status, right? Always open, doesn't really make sense. So how about I make this a ready group? So I'm going to go to the status and I'm going to make this a ready group. And then if I make it a ready group, it expects a shared component, an LOV. I can write my own LOV here. And now that this table is called, well, actually, I don't know. So this table is called to-dos. So if I want to have a query, I would do like a select distinct status normally you would probably denormalize that table, put your status into like a lookup table and such, but let's not do this right now. Let's just do like a quick and easy solution. I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna look at my form again. There you go. Now I have a nice radio group and I can make it even nicer. I can go in and turn things off like extra values. I can update my template options to display this as a pill and stretch it for this. And if I do all of this, then I get a nicer looking radio group where I can make my choices. And it's still not quite what I'm looking for. So let's do one more change. I want to have four values shown in a row. Save this. All right, so this looks better. Well, I guess there's still some improvements, but that should do for now. So this is how you kind of edit your forms. And the next step, what if you want to change your look and feel? We have something that's called the theme roller. And with theme roller, you can change your color scheme. So if this blue and gray doesn't work for you, you can change the color, the header color to, I don't know, something red or, no, well, there you go. Or maybe I go with a little bit more purple. Oh, now it's hanging. Oh, forget about that. Yeah, there you go. A little bit sluggish. Or you can use one of our built-in themes. And one thing that Oracle introduced a while ago is this Redfoot look. So you can change your whole UI to have this Oracle Redfoot look. And then your entire application looks changes to this new color scheme. So you can use this to kind of emulate and recreate your own corporate color scheme and corporate look and feel. Right, so that's that should do it for like a very basic how to build an application with Apex. Let's take a look at a few more resources for you to learn more about Apex. And again, back to apexoracle.com. One area that I would highly recommend is this whole learn section, starting with our tutorials. And these tutorials, they have our hands-on labs. So when you go to like an Oracle conference or other events, we typically do these hands-on labs where you sit in front of a computer, you kind of work your way through this PDF document, and in the end, you kind of build your own basic Apex app. So you can do these at home. You can do this with apexoracle.com. After signing up for Workspace there, you can do it with our cloud services. And it starts out with the spreadsheet lab, similar to what I've just shown you with my high schools. You can learn how to build applications on existing tables. There's this proof of concept app, which is kind of modeled around QuickSQL and the kind of napkin drawing a database model. And then if you want to learn more about how you kind of interact with remote data sources, take a look at these two labs. So the question was there about database links. Database links, like if you're like in your own network, you have like two databases within your own network, database links are certainly an option that you can use. But if you want to talk to remote data sources, if you want to talk from like your on-premise Apex to like the cloud or vice versa, or if you want to talk between different cloud services, then take a look at REST enabled SQL and REST data sources. One allows you to connect to Oracle databases and work very similar to database links in that you can send back and forth SQL and pure SQL. And the other one, REST data sources, are there for you to talk to any kind of external REST API. And then local development and introduction to JavaScript. So once you're ready to do your own customizations, if you want to see how you put your own JavaScript in there, take a look at this lab. All right, next up, our documentation. And for every release, Apex 22 and backwards, you'll find our documentation here on apexoracle.com, learn/documentation. Take a look at the release notes to learn about what changed in every release, what features have been added, what features have been deprecated. Installation guide, if you want to install Apex locally, take a look at the installation guide. It all starts out from apexoracle.com/download. That is taking you to our OTN download page. And here you can download the latest version of Apex. Now, Apex typically ships with the Oracle database. If you download an Oracle XE database, if you download Oracle 12c, 18, 19, then Apex is typically included with it. But we generally recommend going here and downloading the latest version and starting with Apex, with database 21.21c. We no longer ship Apex directly with database because, again, you should always go to get the latest version from here. So you install the Oracle database, you install and configure OAuth, and you install and configure Apex, all of which you can download from OTN. Or you sign up, of course, online with one of our cloud services. Then our education website, also very interesting. If you want to use Apex more professionally, if you want to have an Apex certification, or if you want to use Apex for your own training, right? Like, let's go to education. So there's an Apex certification that you can read up on. If you're a SQL, there's lots of, if you're a student, there's lots of material for you as a student to learn about Apex. There's general training on learning SQL and relational databases, learning application development. But if you're a teacher and you want to kind of teach Apex or just teach SQL to your students, you can also use apexoracle.com for that and download our material here. And if you want to build up your own curriculum, like if you're a teacher in a college, university, or in school, high school, or somewhere, you can download our application development curriculum from here. And it has like a open source license requirements, that document here somewhere. And you can use this curriculum for your own training and for your own teaching. So this is on our education page here. And again, all these links are going to be in those slides. And then lastly, community resources. If you want to learn more about the Apex community, go over here to the community page, take a look at the overview, what kind of events are happening, and what kind of community resources are available to you. And the community resources, first of all, there's Community Central and our Oracle Apex discussion forum. So if you do have any questions and want to reach out to the community, go to this discussion forum. Many of our team members are helping out there. Many Apex developers in the community are helping out there. So click here on Apex discussions and ask your questions and ask for help around Apex. There's also a community site that I highly recommend, Apex World. Apex World has been built entirely by the community. And you'll find links to announcements, tweets, job postings, plugins. If you want to download third-party plugins, you can go in here. So this is the Apex community website. It also talks about this Slack channel. So there's a channel on Slack that has many different subject areas where you can also go in and directly chat with your fellow Apex developers. So this is the Apex community website. I also want to point to our Apex office hours website, apexoracle.com/office-hours. We do have once a month or so webinars where we talk about what's new in Apex, best practices. Like 2 weeks ago, we had this real world low code webinar where our partners talked about Apex. There was a webinar in November on PDF printing with Apex, which was really good. New features in Apex 20.2 we had in October. And we have one coming up on March 17th, which is going to be about MLE and JavaScript in the database. So mark your calendars. Definitely interesting to attend. And all our recordings of past webinars are available down here in this list. All right. I also want to point you to the Oracle Career website. If you're interested in development with Apex, if you're experienced JavaScript developers, the Apex team is expanding. And we are particularly looking for experienced JavaScript developers, not necessarily with lots of Apex background, but if you know JavaScript, if you know React or jQuery or any of these libraries, talk to us, reach out to me, put your application in. We are expanding. And then one thing to really keep handy, apexoracle.com/shortcuts. All these sites that I talked about here are listed on the shortcut page. So you'll find a link to the discussion forum, information about architecture and accessibility, or Apex blogs, books, certifications. So all these resources are listed here on this very handy bookmark list. All right. So with that, I do want to, well, before I get to questions, I do want to point you to this resource here, Apex. Oracle Application Express is called Oracle Application Express, but everyone calls it Apex, and this is, I guess, the proper pronunciation. And if you want to do your own material, if you need any of these logos, there's PNG files and PDF files and Illustrator files, so you can do your own Apex t-shirts and material. All right, so with that, let's look at some of the questions that came in. There you go, let me just open this up. So Suzanne, you ask about whether I showed my high school to the Department of Education. I didn't, I did go to the New York City Open Data website last year, and I talked to some DOE members there who were very interested in it, but yeah, I haven't shown it in any official capacity, but email me, happy to talk more about that. Then database links, can you create a database link to an existing database somewhere? Yes, you can. I talked about that a little bit. If you are within the same network, that's certainly an option. If you're going remotely via HTTP, take a look at REST APIs and REST enabled SQL. Then to do is everything in Espanol. I'm not sure what that means, but it does raise a good point. Apex applications are translatable, and the Apex IDE itself is also translated, so you can actually switch to German or Spanish, French, Chinese, and so on to have this whole IDE run in different languages. And Apex applications themselves have a facility built in that you can get your applications translated. All the translatable strings, labels, headings, and so on can be exported into XLEF, then translated by a professional translator, imported back into your Apex application, and you can run your apps in any language you like. All right, what else do we have? Is there a wizard for converting Oracle Forms to Apex? There's not. We had a Forms migration utility, which is kind of like a project management tool that we no longer include. So there's no wizard that takes like FMB files and generates them into Apex. We feel that a lot of concepts are just too different, but there's certainly a lot of material out there when you look at apexoracle.com that talks about how you go about migrating forms. So, when you look at forms modernization, there's a whole write-up on what to consider, why you want to do it, what the advantages are of Apex, and how you go about it. Thanks for those tutorials. You're welcome. And wow. All right, that is all I have. It's almost one, so I'm going to give it back to the moderators, please.
Thank you. If there are no other questions, we'll go ahead and conclude today's webinar. If there were any unanswered questions, I'll make sure that we include those answers in the email blast that I send out later this afternoon with the slide deck and recording of today's webinar. Thank you again, everyone, for joining us this afternoon. And thank you to Mark for a great presentation. As I mentioned, I'll be emailing you guys at some point later this afternoon with the slide deck. I just wanted to thank Coleman and the New York Oracle Users Group again for their partnership. It's always a pleasure working with you guys. And I hope everyone has a great rest of your day. We'll see you next time for one of our other webinars or workshops. Thanks so much.
All right, thank you.